Let's talk about Power BI Gateway in the enterprise mode. So I'm going to show you how to set up and use the Power BI Gateway to connect to on-premise data. And this time, we're not kidding around. We're talking about the enterprise mode. Now, this tip I had shared in my earlier videos as well. Just a quick reminder, you do not need a paid Power BI license to use the Power BI Gateway. You can use it with a free Power BI license. Now, this video is part of a series on Power BI Gateways. But if you would like to skip the recap and jump right to the discussion on Power BI Gateway Enterprise Mode, then just go ahead and jump to the timestamp shown on your screen right now. Otherwise, I'm stepping into the recap. So in our first video, we had talked about when do you need a Power BI Gateway? And we also talked about ways you can possibly avoid having to use one. In the second video, we covered Power BI Gateway in the personal mode. And here we are in this video, we'll be talking about Power BI Gateway in the enterprise mode. Now you can catch all of these videos by clicking in the corner, or they're going to be links below in the description. So make sure to watch them all. Now, so we're going to be talking about enterprise mode today, Power BI Gateway, and let's get started. Let me introduce myself. My name is Avi Singh. I'm a Microsoft MVP and a best-selling Power BI author. And if you want to become a Power BI pro, then make sure to subscribe. And yes, my friends, click that bell so that you're notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. Now, if you are getting started or if you keep getting stuck in Power BI, also make sure to check out my number one ranked Power BI tutorial and start creating beautiful Power BI dashboards right now. All right, let's get going. Yep, so the links in the corner and down in the description. So Power BI Gateway, we're gonna go through the recap and we'll quickly talk about when do you need a Power BI Gateway and what's this deal between personal mode and enterprise mode. And again, if you wanna skip ahead to the discussion on enterprise mode, how to set it up and everything like that, then just jump to the timestamp shown here. So what is a Power BI Gateway? When do you need it? It's really simple. Once you publish your models to PowerBI.com, then you need a bridge which can let the PowerBI.com cloud model to connect to your on-premise data sources during the refresh. And that bridge is, my friend, the Power BI Gateway. Now, if you have tried installing Power BI Gateway, right away you would see the two options which you are asked to choose from right at the beginning. And the first one there is the top one, which is called the enterprise mode. And the next one down there is the personal mode. Now, the key difference between those two is that the one for the personal mode is really meant for one person to use. And think about the Power BI model author or the administrator, right? So it's one person, he's using that gateway to refresh their own models and they're happy with it. Now, of course, 100 people could be using the reports. It has nothing to do with that. Focus more on the model authors. Now, the Power BI Enterprise lets multiple authors who are publishing the models up on PowerBI.com, but each one of them doesn't have to set up their own personal gateway. They can all have like a central enterprise gateway that they're all connecting through. So it just makes things easier to set up, manage, and administer. Now, typically, enterprise mode gateways are often set up by the IT department or the central BI team, but that is, you know, it's not always so. Sometimes if you have a big enough, let's say finance group or something like that, where you have, maybe 5 or 10 different people authoring and publishing models, it's okay for you to set up your own gateway enterprise mode, right? So, you know, those are the common scenarios where you would find a Power BI Gateway in enterprise mode. So the first step in getting started with that is, of course, download and install. And really the install and download is the same instructions as with the personal mode. So you just go to PowerBI.com, click on that icon shown here, select data gateway from the download list, from the drop-down list, and that would let you download the Power BI Gateway installer. And again, it's the same installer for both modes. Now, of course, the next question is, where should you install the Power BI Gateway? Now, what I'll say is, at least when you're starting out and you're just testing out things, it's definitely okay to install on a laptop with Wi-Fi. That is okay. In fact, if you're just testing things out, it's also okay and allowed to have two installs on the very same machine. In fact, that's what I have on my machine right now. So I have one install of the personal mode gateway and one install of the enterprise mode gateway. So that's okay. But of course, you don't want to keep that around for too long. So what the recommended setup is, definitely a machine, which is not your laptop, which is always on and preferably connected to a wired network, so not going through the wireless Wi-Fi, right? So that will give you better performance. It is recommended that, if possible, you use a machine with a solid state drive because data is often cached on that machine before being sent out the gateway. I think the term is spooling. So the hard drive is used as well, just for interim storage. So solid state drives can help you out there. And the third tip here is that you should locate the data gateway physically close to the data source. And what I mean by that is, imagine if your main data source is, let's say, a specific SQL Server, which hosts your data warehouse. And if you were gonna install the Power BI gateway, might as well do it in a machine which is maybe in the same data center. Now, you probably do not want it on the same machine because usually your database admin wouldn't be too happy about that anyway, right? So they probably wouldn't allow it, and probably that's not recommended. But again, I'll let it be your call. But definitely be aware of that, where these machines are physically located, and put those two as close to each other as possible. So let's get started. Once you open the installer, we have the same warning as last time we saw in the personal mode video. But this time, hopefully, well, if you're testing it, it's okay. But if you're doing it for real, for keepsies, then you probably do want to pay attention to it, and you're installing it on a computer which is always on and with a wired network. And this time we're going to select the option at the top. That one is the enterprise mode, and it's going to say, ooh, time remaining. Such an exciting window. And then it's going to talk to you about the minimum requirements, the install location, you know, simple stuff. And the requirements here, you can take a quick look at that if you like. So recommended. Probably most machines these days do have 8 GB of memory. Most machines are 64 bits. So you normally shouldn't have to worry about any of that. All right. So, and then please wait. And after that, it comes back and says installation was successful and asks you for an email address to use with the gateway. Now, for this one, you want to sign in using the same account you would use to log in to powerbi.com. Now, this would become an admin for the gateway. Don't worry, you can add other admin accounts later on. So if you have other team members who should also be able to administer the Power BI gateway, you can add them later. And again, as I said, Power BI Gateway, that is no requirement for a paid license. You could be doing this on a free license. On the next screen, once you're past that, it is going to ask you to configure a gateway. And the first thing that you need there is the gateway name. Now, of course, if you're part of a really large enterprise, then maybe not right at the beginning, but eventually, if there are lots of different teams setting up their own gateways, you may even want to come up with a naming convention. You may say that, oh, there has to be, the person who set it up, their name has to be there or something like that. You know, so something that kind of keeps things simplified. But again, if you're just starting out, just give it a sensible name. Just don't, you know, yeah, don't call it Mickey Mouse or something, right? That would be my recommendation. Now, the next piece here is the recovery key, and that one is important. My friend Microsoft isn't kidding around here. So gateways, once you set up, and we're going to show you the rest of the setup where you add the data credentials and stuff. And if you have to restore the gateway, this recovery key is going to be really helpful. Otherwise, you might have to painfully add all of the data credentials and everything again. So do save this in a safe place. All right, and that's it. So that at this point, the gateway is set up on the machine, and now we're gonna switch over and look at it on powerbi.com. But before that, I'm just gonna bring this model, which you had seen when we were working on Power BI Gateway in personal mode. And again, it's just a simple model with some data connection to on-premise data sources. So very, very local on my C drive, Excel file, and a local SQL Server. And what we had done was we had published this online to powerbi.com. Let me bring that up. And this was a file, and I haven't refreshed it. And at that time, we were able to use the personal gateway. Now, that's what we had been using. But on the next screen, if now I go to the same file, actually, let me just go back to that again. So again, I went to the data set that was published, and earlier we were using the Power BI personal gateway, right? So this was the earlier screen. But now the refresh screen, you can see that it is detecting my enterprise gateway as well, but all is not well. It is not very happy about it. But I must say that Power BI is really good. I mean, it really guides you through. Now, this part may be not very intuitive, but what you need to do, my friend, is click on this arrow. So view data sources. And it's going to say, it's basically telling you, if you expand that, it's going to tell you, hey, what do you need to do? And let me try this. So if you click on this gear icon, then it takes you to the gateway cluster settings. And by the way, the administrator is right there. My account is added. You can add other accounts, right? But you don't want to click on that gear icon, and I'll tell you why. Because if you clicked on the gear icon, let's see if I can show you in a different window. Let's go here. So by the way, I mentioned this in my earlier video. When you click here and you say manage gateways, click on the gear icon over here, right? And manage gateways, then it doesn't show you personal gateways, but you can see it is showing me all the enterprise mode gateways, right? So that those are being shown here. So earlier, I had to come in here and add data connections and add data source, and it was never fun. I had to kind of guess what I needed to add and all that stuff. So that was not fun. But now what you can do is you can click on this expand button and just use the buttons right here. So you can say, yep, you know, I want to add this one to data gateway, and that gets added. And I'm just going to click add. Oh, wait. Oh, not so fast. I almost did it. So folks, the only gripe that I have is that it gives it a default name. I would have preferred if it did not give it a name and it forced me to type a name, because otherwise I ended up with a lot of data sources called new data source or new data source one or something like that. So make sure you do change that, right? So I'm just going to call it C drive. A local Excel file, and this kind of puzzled me. I'm not really sure why a Windows username is needed, but I'm gonna punch that in anyway, and then I'm gonna click add. Be right back. All right, so that brought me back to this screen again, and we're getting closer. Now if I click on this, we can see that there's a green icon here, but we do have to do one other step, which we have to map it to that. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna add this one and then come back and do the mapping. And again, we're gonna go through the same steps. So, and again, remember to change this. That's a big gotcha, my friend. You don't want a whole bunch of stuff called new data. So it's a SQL Server, and I'm gonna punch in the credentials and be right back. All right, we are looking good. So notice here, it's looking all green, but we still need to map it to here. So these are the data sources which are in the data set. And then we can say that which one is it in my data gateway, right? So I'm matching my data sources in my model to what is in the data set. And that's it. And I'm going to hit apply. And now I'm going to click here and click refresh now. Oops, what did I do? All right, well, I'll click refresh now right there, and we'll check back in a minute or so. Woohoo, so we came back, and our first refresh was something we had done earlier in the day, and that was using the personal gateway, and this time we're using the enterprise gateway, and that one has been completed successfully. So that's it for Power BI Gateway in enterprise mode. And again, make sure to watch our complete series. It's possible that we'll add even more videos in the future, maybe covering common errors or other issues around the Power BI Gateway. And again, if you're just getting started or if you keep getting stuck with Power BI, then make sure to check out my number one ranked Power BI tutorial and get started on creating beautiful Power BI dashboards. Until next time, power on, my friend.
Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.